Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A newly discovered exoplanet poses a radical challenge to the consensus theory of planet and star formation. The massive exoplanet is 11 times the size of Jupiter, yet it circles its parent star at a distance that is 650 times the average distance between the Earth and the Sun. In the conventional theory, which imagines stars and planets forming gravitationally in a collapsing cloud of gas and dust, such a giant planet cannot form at such a vast distance from its star. Lead investigator Vanessa Bailey states, "This system is especially fascinating because no model of either planet or star formation fully explains what we see." What does the Electric Universe theory of planet and star formation tell us about this new discovery?
This discovery doesn't match what astronomers expected to see, for the simple reason that the expectations are based on a model which is centuries old and has never been challenged. In fact, we have another situation rather like that of the flat Earth, where data to the contrary piles up but is not accepted because everyone just knows that the Earth is flat. In the same way, astronomers believe that the planets are formed in a flat disk about a star. But it's been known for decades now, and it was predicted by plasma physicists, those who have indulged in what's known as plasma cosmology, that stars are formed in the equivalent of a cosmic lightning bolt in a molecular cloud. And with the latest infrared telescopes in space and on the ground, it's been possible to actually photograph these stars in infrared, and they are strung like bright beads on a glowing string. So if this is the way condensed bodies are formed, it has nothing to do with a gravitational collapse from a clump of gas and dust, so that all models which attempt to try and explain a system like this one, where we have an 11 Jupiter-sized planet orbiting at 650 times the distance of the Earth from the Sun, you should compare this with Neptune, which is only 30 times the distance of the Earth from the Sun, and that's now our outermost planet in our solar system. So 650 times away, it took some time before it was shown that the planet actually was associated with this particular star. But of course, the problem of forming Neptune has never been answered. How do we form a gas giant at 30 times the distance of the Earth from the Sun? And now we have a planet which is 11 times the size of Jupiter being formed at 650 times the distance of the Earth from the Sun.
An alternative theory considered by mainstream scientists is that distant giant planets may form in a manner comparable to a binary star system. However, the mass ratio between the giant exoplanet and its parent star is more than 10 times too great for this theory to work. Lead investigator Vanessa Bailey states, "This extreme mass ratio is not predicted from binary star formation theories. Just like planet formation theory predicts that we cannot form planets so far from the host star."
Of course, it was suggested that the 11 times Jupiter-sized planet was a kind of failed binary star. But according to astronomers, the mass ratio of two stars in a binary system is typically no more than 10 to 1. In this case, it's about 100 to 1. And this extreme mass ratio is not predicted from binary star formation theories, just like planet formation theory predicts we cannot form planets so far from the host star. One of the problems that astronomers face is that they are using gravity alone to try and explain orbiting systems in space. And without any real understanding of gravity, this is bound to lead to contradictions and discoveries like the one we have here. In the electrical formation model of stars, smaller objects will also be formed along that cosmic lightning bolt. And when they are formed, some of them will be sufficiently close to each other that once the lightning more or less subsides and fades, the two objects will be gravitationally attracted towards one another. The other problem that gravitational theory faces, though, is that capture is a very unlikely process, because if two bodies swing past one another, unless there is a loss of energy between the two, motional energy, then the body passing nearby will merely swing past and then off into deep space. So there has to be something else going on, and capture must be more prevalent than gravitational theory at present can allow. Now, one of the breakthrough ideas in the electric universe model is that gravity itself is a form of dipolar electric force which is dependent upon the charge distribution inside a star. And if there is any exchange of charge at the surface of that star, that will change the gravitational force between two objects. And in fact, it is a means of achieving capture because you're exchanging electrical energy for motional energy. That is, the trajectory of the star coming past another star will be altered in such a way that capture is more certain. Now, the formation of binary systems would seem to follow naturally from the formation nearby in a cosmic lightning bolt. But as I said, objects of different sizes, including the sizes of gas giants, will also be formed in that cosmic lightning bolt, so that capture of an object 11 times the size of Jupiter at a distance of 650 times the Earth-Sun distance from a star is far more likely and is explicable. It's even predictable. I wish to emphasize that there is more than one way to form a planetary system electrically. A common alternative is for a star to electrically eject matter in a nova outburst to form a so-called hot Jupiter. The discovery of hot Jupiters closely orbiting their parent stars is simply another mystery for the accretion disk story.
The discovery of seemingly baffling exoplanets may inevitably force a reconsideration of our own solar system.
In an earlier space news, I talked about the improbability of our planetary system having been formed according to the disk of dust and gas and gravitational collapse model. The more exoplanets that are being found, and the number in the hundreds or even thousands now, the more the gravitational model of the formation of the solar system comes into question. Because exoplanets have been found which orbit in planes other than the so-called ecliptic or the equatorial plane of the star, and some planets have been found which orbit in a retrograde fashion, the opposite direction to other planets in that system. None of these fit a gravitational collapse model, so that we have to look at a kind of modified dynamics, modified gravitational model, which can allow capture and also provide stability, because the other elephant in the room is that gravitational theory alone does not predict stability. A gravitational system suffering minor perturbations has no means of correcting them so that they grow over time and result in the expulsion of planets from the system. But that's not what we observe either here in our solar system or in some of these other crazy systems of exoplanets where the exoplanets seem to do almost what they like. An independent Jupiter-sized object will always be a minor star in an electric universe. A Jupiter-sized object outside the Sun's immediate electrical influence, beyond the heliosphere, will be a secondary focus for interstellar Birkeland current filaments, like those powering the Sun. The Jupiter-sized object will naturally be a brown dwarf star radiating mostly in the infrared. Now, the process of entry of a brown dwarf star inside the heliosphere results in its electrical power being shut off, so that it becomes a gas giant planet. The sudden change on entering the Sun's electrical domain results in the new gas giant discharging matter to achieve electrical balance. That discharged matter forms cometary material, a ring of debris, and numerous satellites. So it's easy to see that the Sun's family of distant gas giant planets were captured. Saturn, with its spectacular rings, was merely the latest addition to the Sun's family. So the solar system is an adopted family with a complex recent history. Of course, mathematical theorists will not like this, but those with a forensic approach will enjoy the new challenges opened up in an electric universe.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.